Hello and welcome to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Coming up, we're going to take a look at the latest updates to Office 365 for admins, starting with the new adoption content pack that allows you to track user adoption of Office 365 services, including things like licensed versus active users in the service, the apps that are used most for communication, usage trends for collaboration and services like OneDrive and SharePoint, and we'll even show you updates to the admin centers for SharePoint and Teams and Skype, as well as Message Center updates. To do this, I'm joined by Ann Michaels, who is responsible for the admin center.
Thank you. Always great to be on the show.
So thanks for being here today. A lot of announcements that we've had around Office 365 administration. It sounds like the whole room is full of Office 365 admins, which is awesome. So in the last couple of months, we've done some great things, especially for enterprise admins. The highly anticipated, long talked about adoption content pack in Power BI. It's available now in preview. Hopefully you guys have been trying that out since May.
Yes, we are really excited about the adoption. Office 365 adoption content pack and Power BI. The usage reports in the admin center, they are a good starting point for you to understand how your organization is using and adopting Office 365. But many of you have shared that you want to further analyze the data and that you might want to understand how your organization is using the entire suite of products or how specific departments are using Office 365. And that's where Power BI and the adoption content pack can help you with.
And the cool thing is, because we're using Power BI, it's all very interactive. You can query it, you can customize it. It's a powerful tool, hence the name.
Absolutely. Let me show you. So what you're seeing here is our pre-built dashboard that gives you a cross-product view of how your organization is using and adopting Office 365. And for most of the reports, for most of the data, we also show you information for the last 12 months so that you can easily see trends in usage.
And I can see here the dashboard's divided around areas like adoption, communication, collaboration. Can you drill into some of those areas a bit more?
So each area gives you specific usage insights. Adoption, for example, offers a high-level summary of adoption trends. Then communication highlights the products that you use the most to communicate, like Exchange, Skype, and Yammer. And collaboration, similarly, shows you how your organization leverages OneDrive and SharePoint to collaborate. When you click into any of these tiles, you can get deeper information. Let's take a look at the adoption overview report, because this is a really good starting point for you to understand how your organization is using and adopting Office 365, because it shows you the number of enabled users, this is your licensed users, in comparison to the number of active users, and you can also see returning users month over month, as well as first-time users. By default, this report gives you information at the Office 365 level, but you can also switch to a product-specific view. We have built contextual filters like this one into many of the reports so that you can easily slice and dice the data and get the information that is relevant for you.
So this is really great. I can see how the usage view would also help focus in terms of where I might want to prioritize things like user adoption training, maybe communication as to things people should be using versus other habits they might have currently. This is really great and powerful for admins that want to communicate to their users.
Correct. And one of the big advantages that the content pack has over the usage reports is that it also shows you where your users are located. As you can see here in the map, I can easily assess where my users are. Because what the content pack does is that it takes all your users' usage information and it combines it with your user information in Azure Active Directory. So you can pivot by ID attributes such as location, as we can see here. And in other reports, we are also bringing in information about departments and organization. So as long as your information in AD is up to date, then you can get some really great insights.
Now we've got a lot of admins here that can probably customize reports in Power BI. Is there anything I can do to really customize and tweak the views we've got?
Definitely. Because of course, all of you have very specific questions that you want to have answers to. So we have made sure that you can customize the content pack. And the power of the content pack really lies in the underlying data. So there are three ways how to customize the content pack. You can either take one of the reports that we have created, like the adoption overview report, and modify it. All you have to do is click on the little edit icon at the top. Or you can also create your own visuals using all the data sets that we have. Or when you open this in Power BI desktop, you can also bring in additional data sources.
Very cool. And so before we go further, I know a lot of people are wondering, how do you get all this stuff wired up into your tenant so I can actually start using this right now?
So let's jump into the admin center, because the first thing that you need to do is kick off the data preparation from the usage reporting page in the admin center. On that page, you will see a card for the adoption content pack in Power BI. The data preparation normally takes between 2 and 48 hours, depending on the size of your tenant. In our case here today, I've already taken care of that, save us some time. So I already see the button here that takes me straight to Power BI.
Right, and one of the requests that I've gotten from a lot of people are maybe a CIO or somebody at a higher level that shouldn't be tweaking settings and configurations in the admin portal. If they have too much access, it can be dangerous, right? How do we give them access to the reporting they probably want without giving them access to all the admin controls that you don't want them to mess with?
So you can do that, of course, using the built-in sharing capabilities that we have in Power BI. But what we also announced this week at Ignite is the new reports reader role that you can assign to anybody in your organization directly in the admin center. And when you assign somebody that role, they will be able to access the usage reports and the content pack, while at the same time, you can make sure that they cannot accidentally configure or change any settings that you have set.
Oh, come on, this is amazing stuff. Reports role, it's a non-admin role for people to actually track usage. This is good stuff. A lot of you have been asking us for this for a long time. So a lot of admins also want to know how their organizations are using new stuff, like maybe Microsoft Teams. Do we have insights around that, something newish in that sense?
We have, or we will have very soon. We just announced this week that we're adding 2 new usage reports to the admin center that will help you understand how your organization is using Microsoft Teams. And we're also adding a new card to the main dashboard that gives you a quick overview and that shows you at one glance how many of your users are active in Teams. Then when you dive into the reports, we first have the Microsoft Teams user activity report. And that report really shows you how your users are using Microsoft Teams and what activity is most popular in your organization, like chat messages or meetings or calls. The second report is the Microsoft Teams app usage report. This report helps you understand how your people connect to Microsoft Teams, including mobile apps, of course, as well.
That's really helpful, and I can see how this information, can you also see how the information is in the adoption content pack? Can we get that as well in the Power BI experience?
Not yet,
okay.
But very, very soon. We announced this week that the adoption content pack in Power BI, yes, we could not have thought of a longer name, will reach GA at the beginning of 2018, and it will be renamed to Office 365 Usage Analytics.
Okay.
The GA version will include more information, especially more data and metrics around teamwork. And we will bring in all the usage data about Microsoft Teams, about Office 365 groups, and also Yammer groups.
Show us.
I will. So what you're seeing here is a first view of the new dashboard that, of course, for all the product, the cross-product views, will include data around Microsoft Teams. We're also adding new reports to the dashboard, and we're adding an entire new section on social collaboration that will help you understand how your people use Microsoft 365 for teamwork, and especially how they leverage Microsoft Teams to do so. We're adding a new report specifically for Microsoft Teams that does not only show you how many active users you have, but that also shows you how many active teams you have and how activity in Teams has evolved over time.
Great, so there's also a new admin center that we're bringing out for Teams and for Skype and kind of a unified experience. Can you give us a preview of that?
Sure. So to enable you to better manage the various aspects of Microsoft Teams and Skype for Business, we're introducing a new Microsoft Teams and Skype admin center that will become available to all of you later in the year. The new admin center, we have here a sneak peek at the new homepage.
It's got a very descriptive name, I might add.
That's correct, yes.
Microsoft Teams and Skype for Business admin center.
And that is correct, very descriptive, so that you really always know where you are.
Right.
But so this new admin center brings together the various tools that we have today and then consolidates them into one single coherent admin experience so that you have a one-stop location to manage all the aspects of both Microsoft Teams and Skype What you're seeing here is really a first mock-up of the homepage that will show you important information, like, for example, call quality or call volume.
Very cool. So we're also working on a brand new SharePoint Admin Center experience. I know a lot of people love seeing this with Jeff Tepper a couple days ago, but can we show that?
So the new SharePoint Admin Center, which is available to all of you in preview right now and will become available or will hit GA at the beginning of next year, makes it really more effective for you to manage SharePoint. The homepage shows you important information, like you can see directly how your organization is using SharePoint as we're bringing in all the information from the usage reports. At the bottom, we're bringing in notifications from the Message Center so that you can always stay up to date with new features in SharePoint and in OneDrive. And you can also directly see if there are any incidents that your tenant is currently impacted by.
So do we have any other improvements that we're making to help our admins out?
Definitely. So many of you have shared that you want to have more visibility into new features that are rolling out to your tenant, and specifically also if there are any actions that you need to take. So we also announced a lot of improvements to the Message Center this week.
Right, and having better visibility when features start to roll out is super important for admins to prepare. And you might want to train, say, for example, your help desk or end users or the training staff themselves and possibly build adoption campaigns and plans to get people using the new technology.
Exactly. And to help you with that, we are introducing the concept of major updates. Because you, of course, today receive a lot of messages in the Message Center. That is part of our transparency promise to you. Mm-hmm. But going forward, we're adding a new carousel to the top of the Message Center that highlights all the announcements related to major updates. So what are major updates? Well, major changes in your tenant. Like, for example, if we are rolling out a new service or a new application, or if there's a change that requires an admin action. For all the major updates, you will receive 3 notifications, both in your Message Center and also via email. The first notification.
Hold on. Email notification, is this real?
This is real.
Hey, email notification. You guys have been asking for this for a while. So it's like a newsletter or something, right?
Correct. And you will receive 3 notifications. One, when we announce the major update. A second one, when it starts to roll out to first release. And a third one, when the feature starts to roll out broadly. And the notification that you receive when the feature goes into first release will state very clearly how long the feature will stay in first release, so that you know exactly how much time you have to plan for it.
This is really cool, because even though we expect that all of you are going into the admin portal every single day to look at the Message Center to see what's rolling out, it probably isn't that realistic to assume that that's happening for everyone. So this is really going to be helpful in terms of getting the modalities of communication that you want.
That's correct. But many of you have also shared that you want to get this information directly to your inbox, not only for major updates, but for all of the notifications in the Message Center.
Right.
And that's what the Weekly Digest helps you with. The Weekly Digest is a summary of all of your Message Center messages that comes directly to your inbox on a weekly basis. And the Weekly Digest has now reached GA and has started to roll out to all customers worldwide.
Very cool. So you can configure all of this with preferences via the Admin Center and get the modality again that you want to have. So this is something that you guys have wanted for a long time. Something else that folks have been asking for a long time as well is the ability to home your users in multiple geographies. So we've also announced multi-geo capabilities this week to also be able to store data in the regions of your choice based on, say, data residency needs that you might have, right?
Exactly. For those of you that have data residency needs, we introduced multi-geo capabilities in Office 365 this week. And with this feature, you can now have a single tenant that spans across multiple Office 365 data center geos. And at the same time, you can decide, you can choose for each of your users where their Office 365 data at rest is stored. And that works both for existing users, for new users, of course, and you can also move existing users.
So here's what that looks like. So for example, if I have a new user, I can actually define where they start, so where their data stores are going to begin from. And if I've got an existing user, I can actually move them out of one geo into another. And we've actually just released a video on this for Microsoft Mechanics this week, where we kind of describe the different paths and ways to do this using PowerShell to move users around if they're pre-existing in your tenant. Once you've already done that, what that looks like is you'll have an enumeration of the various sites that you've actually configured for things like the OneDrive admin center or other locations where you've got multiple geographies. So mailboxes, other things can be in other geographies as well. So a really cool experience here, especially if you've got those data residency needs where you want to have, for example, some users' data reside in Europe, some in North America, some in Asia Pacific, we can now do that. So very cool stuff. So thank you. So what's the best way then to experience all of these new updates?
So some of them are available for you to use today. For example, the reports reader role, you can assign that to users in your admin center today. The Microsoft Teams report, you have to wait a little bit longer, but not long, mid-October, that's when we will start rolling that out. The other updates, like the new SharePoint Admin Center and the new Microsoft Teams and Skype Admin Center, those will become available over the next couple of months. Simply keep an eye out for notifications in your Message Center, of course.
So, and of course, you can check out the link shown, because we actually have, I've actually linked to the Message Center if you're logged in, and you can use the AKA link that will pop up in just a second. And of course, if you want to hear all of the updates, oh, there it is. If you want to hear all the updates around not only Office 365 Admin and SharePoint and everything else across Microsoft, keep checking back to Microsoft Mechanics. That's all the time we have for this show. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Thank you.